iSet, which is available, started as of 2016 in Pennsylvania here. And it's definitely something that I think that people forget. Well, maybe they've gotten by without it for so long, and then they try to go for a promotion or they try to go for a new job, and it just doesn't happen. Yeah. So we want people to really start thinking about that and realize that it's not just something that's going to take them forever. You know, it wouldn't take them that long anyway. And we just try to help them get that, get that success and try to move on with their lives.
For some reason, high school didn't work out for them. They weren't able to get that degree. And there can be any number of circumstances. Mm-hmm. And it really has nothing to do with intelligence.
Right.
As much as it does with circumstances of their lives.
Yeah. Everyone has something else going on and different reasons and different, you know, and we don't care about that, honestly. Mm-hmm. We just want to help them, you know, get past that and get that goal and get a job and maybe post-secondary education if that's what they want, some kind of training. And we're located right in the career link, so it's nice because it's a nice central hub of being able to look for a job, get your education while you're there. One-stop shop, as we like to call it.
Walk out one door and into the other.
Correct.
I like that. Well, you mentioned helping, and Tammy, tutoring is available as well, because maybe they need to brush up on some skills before they are able to take the test or just to get themselves better in their mindset.
Yes, we offer tutoring opportunities. And we do that not only for the GED students, but even English as a second language also. Mm. That's another component of our adult education classes. But yeah, we always value our tutors, you know, because again, some of our students, because of work schedules and that, they might not be able to attend class schedule.
Sure.
So they might need tutoring. And because of their own, some of their basic needs. So we do adult basic education also. So there's tutor opportunities out there in the community that we try to get community tutors to do some, like for reading and math.
Yeah.
And like I said, we do English as a second language. We also do working with the high school equivalency. And we've even done people with driver's license, you know, had some tutors working with individuals to get driver's license, CDL license. You know, just some of that extra support that they want to move on in their career.
So help us to drill down a little bit. How does someone take advantage of these services?
Well, they would contact me. You mean to become a volunteer tutor?
Both. If somebody needs to be tutored or if somebody wants to be a tutor.
Oh, okay. Well, I will tell you. Can tell what if they need to be a tutor.
If they're looking for classes, we offer classes at the Indiana County Career Link Mondays through Thursday from 9 to 11:30. We have an orientation where they come in, and to take advantage of our tutoring opportunity to use and utilize a tutor, you would have to come in through our orientation and be assessed, and they would simply do that by either giving us a call at 724-463-5300, and my extension is 2305, or they can visit our website, which has all of our information and more detail about our classes and the requirements and some of the expectations that we require of some of our students. And our website is www.iu28.org. And if you go under departments, we are Center for Education. And that's where they can find a lot of our information and everything about tutoring, volunteering, classes, even some differences between the two tests available that they can take now.
We might have an image in our mind of what a typical student in need of a GED or a high school diploma might be. Let's dispel some of that, because probably it runs the gamut, doesn't it?
It does. It really does. We've had kids who have just been right out of high school and something happened. And so we've got everyone from 18 up to people in their 60s who've just had this goal in mind for their entire lives, but they've never needed it. But then they want to achieve that diploma. And what's really nice is we actually have every year a very nice graduation ceremony for our students and we have the caps and gowns, and IUP Communications Media comes over and they take really nice photos, and it's just something that they never got. And their families come in, and we have it at the Career Link. It's just a really nice event, and we like to share that with everyone. Yeah. There's definitely all different walks of life in the classroom, and we are a very easygoing place. You know, we're gonna try to work with you, whether it's flexibility for your schedule or, you know, we know people with childcare, transportation. What's nice is we're on the bus route at the Career Link. So there's definitely ways to get there. If you need to get it, you know, there's ways to do it.
Gonna fix you up.
Yes.
Gonna fix you up. Tammy, let's talk about the person who is maybe the typical tutor. Obviously, there must be qualifications in order to do that.
Well, and we have different areas of tutoring. You can tutor in the classroom, and so the qualifications would be different than to be an actual tutor one-to-one. Mm-hmm. So what they would do is contact me, And some of the qualifications, they ask for some higher education to be an actual tutor, and that's because we're always trying to improve our the experience with the students and everything. And then a classroom aide could just have a high school degree themselves, a diploma, and be able to work as a tutor. But for the tutoring, and they get some different opportunities. Some people like one-to-one, some like a small group to tutor, you know. And so that provides, we pair them up. We try to match them to what the tutor's interested in, what they feel comfortable. And, of course, the tutor has to go through some tutor training. Mm-hmm. And we offer workshops for the tutors to continue their training. And we also encourage the tutors to be part of the other programs, too. English as a Second Language. We'll have an open house once a year. And we have our tutors there. And the tutors come to our graduation, too. Oh, yeah. And so it's part of the community, networking. And during the graduation, we always try to recognize the tutors. We give them a little token, a handcrafted thing that I try to make to, you know, just
You make it yourself?
Them. Yes, I do. I like to make crafts. So, and then I had this quote that just recently I came upon from Elizabeth Andrew. And it says, volunteers do not necessarily have the time. They just have the heart.
Oh, yeah.
And that is something that, you know, because everybody's so busy. Mm-hmm. But we really need our tutors in the community, both at Indiana and Armstrong, because of our students, some of their needs, you know, and it's so much more personal. It's kind of, you know, they match up one-to-one. Now, of course, you meet at a public place, and we make sure everything is, you know, comfortable safe. And safe.
Sure,
you know?
Sure. It's interesting you mentioned individual as opposed to in small group settings. I would guess one works for one person, and another would be more advantageous for someone else. Maybe someone who isn't as outgoing might have questions that they're hesitant to give voice to, but somebody else in the group might have that same question and they would give voice to it. And so they could really glom onto is not really the proper way to put it. They could take advantage of getting that same question answered maybe in a different context.
Yes, and we try to encourage cohorts too. And sometimes because with they're all from different aspects of life. Mm-hmm. And sometimes, again, we know in learning, it's always kind of better if they have each other to be kind of accountable, even to show up for class.
For sure. A support system that they might not have at home.
Yeah.
So. Yeah.
Yeah. You need that support system, don't you?
Definitely.
In a lot of cases, that might be why they didn't get their degree in the very first place.
Sometimes I feel like we're life coaches, not just teachers and instructors. We're trying to really boost confidence. And some of these people are they're ready to take the test, but they just don't have that extra push. So we like to give them that push anyway.
Now, do you actually administer the test or is that done in another way?
So actually, there are two different ways to take the test. The GED is given at IUP, and they can sign up online and create an account on there and sign up and schedule. But the HISET we actually give through Aaron, and that's given twice a month through Aaron's central office, which is out on towards 422. And we all that they would have to do is create an account online, sign up, they pay online. We used to give it over the Career Link. But with everything that had changed, when the test changed a little bit, we had to, you know, adapt. So we do give the HISET test, which is a little bit less expensive than the GED. So we've a lot of our students, we've seen a lot of success with that.
Yeah.
But that is given through Aaron.
Okay. All right. Well, the need is there. Certainly you have plenty of candidates out there who are in need of that GED, that high school diploma. And so you're meeting that need. And,
yes.
And that's a wonderful thing. It's absolutely wonderful. So give the contact information again. Somebody's listening this morning says, I would like to get started on that path. I stepped off that road a long time ago, but I want to get back on it.
So there's a lot of ways to contact us. They can stop into the Indiana County Career Link or even Armstrong if someone's listening from Armstrong County. Both of those, we're there all the time, so they can definitely give us their information from that way. They can give us a call at 724-463-5300, and our extension is 2305. Or they can check out our website, which, of course, has all of our information, which is www.iu28.org. And again, under departments, we're Center for Education. So, yeah, anyway, there's a lot of ways to contact us.
One other question that just came to my mind was, are these done by session? In other words, class starts on this date, another class will be starting on that date down the road, or can people just join when it's time for them, when they feel right in their hearts?
Our classes are kind of an open enrollment. Every month we have an orientation. If a new student comes in, they have to go through an orientation, and we have that once a month. But they are able to just kind of jump in, and we just kind of accommodate them and fit them into the class. That way, no one is left out, and you know, if there's a deadline or something that they need to really get this by a certain time, we try to work with them and, you know, getting them a tutor if that's what we need, or we just try to help them out as much as we can.
It's terrific. Sounds wonderful. Yes. Folks, you're there. You have that need. They can help meet it at Aaron. Ladies, thanks so much
for coming in, visiting with us.
We appreciate it so very much. It is the voice of Indiana County, WCCS, AM 1160 and 101.1 FM.